this again. Because I've tried this about 3 or 4 times and everything hasn't working out, you know. So here we go. Bowl season, it starts today. And we know all the bowl games. Originally, this was supposed to come out last night. But unfortunately, you know, we had some issues around here. So it's coming out today. First things first, there's 12 SEC teams in a bowl game, including 2-8 South Carolina. No Army. Well, some bowl games were canceled. Pac-12 was like, okay, we're just not going to play this bowl season. We're not going anywhere. So most of the Pac-12 out. So that's why Army doesn't get to go to a bowl game. It sucks. Bowl tie-ins do suck. It kind of needs to go away because there are a lot of mediocre teams. I get it. This is one of those. This is a crazy year. This is a weird year. But that does not mean, that definitely does not mean some of these teams deserve it. In fact, there should be less bowl games than that. And there should be, you know, we should, you know, rematch, you know, some of these teams and some of these bowls because some of these matchups are unappealing. And there's a couple that I want to talk about on New Year's Day and January the 2nd that look, you know, very unappealing, you know. Let's just get the non, you know, New Year's 6, New Year's Day bowls out the way first. Citrus, we got Northwestern taking on Auburn. Auburn's like, what, the 4th or 5th best team in the SEC, so it doesn't really matter all that much. But at least Auburn has a winning record. At least Auburn has a winning record. Can't say that for NC State. Kentucky, though. Kentucky is, what, 4-6 playing in the Gator Bowl. Come on now. Come on. We could have pulled some strings. I mean, I don't really care that Missouri's, you know, 5-5. They're 500 at least. A much better matchup than Kentucky. And that would have been so much better on New Year's Day. Oh, you know, Indiana's pissed. They're in the Outback Bowl taking on the Lane Train and Ole Miss. Yeah, I'd be pissed off too. I'd be very angry. Very much angry about that. No Michael Penix for the rest of the year. Completely just shafted by the College Football Playoff Committee. There's some other key bowl games. I think I will watch these games. I'm not sure. But this will be that first Saturday of bowl season, which will be this Saturday, December 26th. And that will be one, the Cure Bowl, Liberty, Coastal Carolina rematch, or rather, this is supposed to be a match in the regular season. We all know we didn't get that matchup. We got the Mormons versus Mullets matchup instead, which was a great matchup. Very, the best matchup of the season. And also the First Responders Bowl, I think that's what it's called. Louisiana, Sun Belt West Division champions, should have played Coastal Carolina. You know, we should have just went on with the Sun Belt championship irregardless. But we did get that. We did not get that at all. So instead, the West Division champs will take on a resurging UTSA team. Now, again, the Conference USA kind of messed things up as regards to, you know, tiebreakers and stuff like that. But I get it. You know, it doesn't really matter. UAB ended up being the champions of Conference USA anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Also, keep an eye on the Arizona Bowl on December the 31st. San Jose State, Ball State, two champions, Mountain West champions, and the MAC champions. So yeah, and again, UAB is taking on 2-8 South Carolina. Disgusting. But now that we can, you know, get away from those bowl games, you know, all that nonsense, let's talk about the rest of the New Year's Six. And, yeah, North Carolina is going to take on A&M in the Orange Bowl, the Aggies, number 5 in the country. Obviously, they are angry at where they ended up, you know. I get it. I get it, the sentiment. But unfortunately, you know, and I really thought about this all night. And it's like, A&M didn't beat anybody but Florida. And that win was a three-loss Florida. I get it. We're in a pandemic. I get it. But it is a three-loss Florida team now. Disgusting. Just disgusting. And the only other team they played in the SEC that was any good was Alabama. We couldn't get A&M Georgia. We couldn't get, you know, those types of matchups, which is rather unfortunate. We didn't get those. I don't think we even got Auburn, Florida. We didn't get that matchup. Kind of sucks that we didn't, but it's okay. It's perfectly fine. But, you know, of course, North Carolina, very good team. They've earned their Orange Bowl spot, you know. And, I mean, just a damn good team. I mean, if it weren't for those two mishaps earlier in the year, Florida State and, what, Virginia, I think. You know, I think North Carolina would come into this game with just one loss, you know. And, I mean, it would be just a single L, you know. But whatever. The Peach Bowl, that will be the game that starts out New Year's Day alongside the Citrus Bowl. It will be number 8 Cincinnati, because they're not number 6 for some reason. In fact, you know, the BCS, the old BCS system has gotten it right 7 out of 7 years, but at least Cincinnati was number 6 in the BCS poll that would have came out had the BCS still existed. They'd be number 6. They'd be on the outside looking in still. But it doesn't matter. Taking on a resurgent Georgia team who's probably going to be, you know, have some players opt out, and we're probably going to hear, blah, blah, blah. These players opted out. That's why Georgia lost. And blah, blah, blah. La, la, la. And, or, you know, if we could hear the other side of the argument, Cincinnati didn't deserve to go to the playoff. They didn't deserve a New Year's 6 spot. They didn't deserve this, blah, 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 blah. Shut up. I don't want to hear it. It's going to be a great game, honestly. And, you know, we're going to have some fun with this one. It's going to be a very fun game. A high-flying offense, very good defense. You know, it's always a recipe for great games. On December the 30th, I don't know why this game, you know, isn't on New Year's Day, because it's a traditional New Year's Day bowl game. In fact, we could push the Gator Bowl back to December the 30th, please. But yeah, on December the 30th, it will be the Cotton Bowl. Oklahoma, number 6. Don't know why they're number 6. They're not supposed to be number 6. They have 2 losses. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if they're playing better now. That's not number 6 team material with 2 losses. Especially when there's teams with zeros and ones in front of their resume that say, hey, we don't have any losses. We have 1 loss. And we're better. You know, yeah, it's all subjective and stuff like that with the polls. But whatever. Number 6, Oklahoma. Okay, who's their opponent in the Cotton Bowl? How about number 7, Florida? 3 loss. Number 7, Florida. I don't know why Florida's still ranked number 7. I mean, again, the BCS would really change these matchups too much, except for the fact that Indiana would probably be in the New Year's 6 instead of Iowa State. But that's okay. That's perfectly fine. I'm not going to dwell on that anymore. I'm going to dwell on it. Yeah. Kyle Trask is likely to win the Heisman Trophy. If not, I don't know what in the world to say. He's played like the best player in college football this year. I mean, it doesn't really matter that Florida's a 3-loss team. I mean, hey, RG3 and Baylor, you know, they had 3 losses. Louisville had 3 losses when Lamar Jackson won it. So, I mean, it doesn't really matter. Kyle Trask, gonna win the Heisman, in my opinion. And Oklahoma, again, resurgent, improving, getting even better each and every week. And, you know, it's going to be fun. It's going to be a fun game, let me tell you that. And last, certainly not least, is the Fiesta Bowl. Oregon, the Pac-12 champions. Pac-12 is so irrelevant that only two teams are going bowling. Guess who the other team is? Guess who they're facing? That will be Colorado, the Buffaloes of Colorado, taking on my Texas Longhorns, the Alamo Bowl. So, you know, we're going to have an Alamo Bowl preview. Yay! I'm not excited for that, to be completely honest with you. But anyway, Fiesta Bowl. Oregon, Iowa State. Again, this is probably one of the best seasons in Iowa State history. And the fact that the Fiesta Bowl is taking Oregon is kind of a sham. And the fact that we have conference tie-ins and stuff, the bowls, is really, really dumb. Really, really dumb. We're talking super dumb, you know. New Year's, to earn a right to play on New Year's Day, this is, to earn a right to play on New Year's, either January 1st, January 2nd, it just so happens to be January 1st and January 2nd this year. To earn the right to play on New Year's Day is a privilege. It should be a privilege. It should be the best teams playing on New Year's Day. There is no way that a Kentucky team should be playing on New Year's Day. Throw that out the window right now. Where is Coastal Carolina at? Why are they not here on New Year's Day? I'd love to see NC State, Coastal Carolina on New Year's Day. Forget about bowl tie-ins. I'd love to see that game. What about Louisiana? I'm sure people want Louisiana New Year's Day bowl game too. Put them with Indiana. Put them with Indiana in the Outback Bowl. This doesn't make any sense. I can see why the Citrus Bowl has the matchup it has. It's the best bowl game outside of the New Year's Six. But I mean, come on. Come on. To have Ole Miss and Kentucky, to have teams like Tennessee earn bowl bids. Now, Army could still technically take a bowl bid because of Tennessee and because of South Carolina, you know, those teams, you know, there's some teams that just probably do not want to play a bowl game. And there could be more opt-outs. There were plenty of opt-outs yesterday. I know Boise State was one of them. And considering, you know, it's believed that Boise State had a hand in Army not going to a bowl game. But who knows? I don't know. I don't really care. I know that Army got shafted. It's not really Boise State's fault or anything. It's the Pac-12's, actually. Because the Pac-12 is incompetent. So, yeah. There we go. We did it. We finally got the video made and finally got everything done. New Year's Day is going to be fun. New Year's 6 is going to be fun. I will preview all 9 of these games along with the Alamo Bowl, which is what my Longhorns are in. So, you know, expect an Alamo Bowl preview coming up soon. And as far as the rest of the week goes, you know, same stuff as last week and weeks before. Of course, NBA starts this week, so there's going to be a video on that. And I'll see you guys in a couple hours, or maybe about 30 minutes or so, to talk about college basketball. See ya.